Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Breathitt County High School baseball field and another great evening of high school 14th region baseball. This is Chuck Price and along with Matt Hudson, the man, the myth, the legend, and we're going to try to bring you some good local action tonight here on the diamond. Looks like tonight Breathitt County Bobcats will be facing the Lee County Bobcats, who made this short trip up Highway 52 to come up here and have a battle of the cats. So we'll see how it goes. The players are being introduced right now. And it's a beautiful night here in Jackson. I want to thank everybody for listening tonight. Just want to hope that you really enjoy this. We're trying. This is our second try at doing some baseball, and at least for me it is. And I just appreciate everybody listening and all the good feedback we got from last time. So we're going to try our best to bring it to you this evening.
Your center fielder, number 10, Dylan Steisney.
So Lee County coming up from, like I said, from Bateville, just a short trip. Looks like right now, try to give you a few stats here.
Number four, Wyatt Spencer. Number five, Chase Hawks. Number 46.
Just recently came off of the game. They've had a couple tough games. They played at Wolf County and Estill County over the last couple days, in the 14th and the 16th, a couple home games, and lost those games. They've had wins this year. Looks like over Cordia, Berea, Housley County, and Buckhorn so far. So. Coach Jason.
Jason plays the national anthem, so we're going to kick it out real quick for a commercial break. We'll be right back here on BSN.
What keeps you going? Your love for the game? Your teammates? A victory? At ARH Orthopedics, our goal is to keep you pain-free so your body can keep going. There's no time for discomfort in your joints or ligaments caused by an injury. ARH Orthopedic providers specialize in treatment plans from non-surgical and surgical options, so your care is entirely centered around you. Visit arh.org/ortho to find an orthopedic provider near you. ARH, more for Appalachia.
Appalachian Wireless is all in on tech madness. Right now, select devices get up to $500 off on the Appalachian Advantage Unlimited or nationwide mix and match plans with renewed or new lines. Plus, use a trade-in for additional savings of up to $250 for a possible savings of up to $750. See AppalachianWireless.com for complete terms and conditions. It's tech madness with up to $750 off because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Go Time is a locally owned and operated convenience store that has all your wants and needs in one stop. We have everything from quick snacks and cool drinks, a full-service deli, fresh coffee bar, soft-serve ice cream, and milkshakes. Also, make sure to check out our Little Caesars pizzas. Go Time, where the customer always comes first. Refuel your tank, refill your cup, and refresh your taste buds all in one stop at Go Time.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back. Welcome back. This is Chuck Price bringing you some BSN baseball tonight here in Jackson. If you can hear me over the music, that's good. If not, just sit back and enjoy a little bit of little old-time rock and roll by Bob Seger. We'll surely talk Matt. My buddy Matt Hudson's with me tonight doing color, and we will definitely be talking some good music and some good movies while we're doing this to help keep this going. So as we said, Lee County made the trip down Highway 52 this evening to come to the Bobcats Den, and looks like they're ready. They got nice blue uniforms, the red stripe and gray pants. Bobcats are also blue shirts, no red stripe, and white pants is the home team tonight. So obviously Lee County will be batting first. Brady Tincher, senior, will be the starter for the Bobcats tonight. He's actually... Matt, as I was looking at it, he has a zero ERA this year. Now, I don't know how many innings. I don't know how many innings you have to have. And bear with me, I'm looking for my. Let's see. Oh, I'm
over. Brady's good, but zero.
Yeah, that's pretty good. I don't think he's had quite enough innings to qualify as a zero ERA yet. But he's dandy. He's really gotten better this year. We've watched him throw a little bit throughout the season. And he's really gotten good. He's got some college offers this year, not necessarily to pitch, but to play. Real good athletic young man, good family. Looks like the Bobcats will have Robbie Turner catching. Robbie had a decent game the last time out. Breathitt, I think this weekend, had a three-team round-robin tournament, or not tournament, but a game here at Breathitt, and they won both those games. And so it was a good turning point. These two teams played about a month ago at Lee County, with Breathitt coming out on top. We'll see this year how, or this game tonight, how it turns out. All right. So first batter for Lee County tonight is Landon Shelton, number 11. And he showed a bunt first. Let's see what happens. A little bit high. I cannot see the scoreboard from where I'm at, but we'll figure it out. It's 1-1. Matt's got the center field camera, so bear with us. Sometimes that second baseman likes to creep into that picture. If he does, you know, we'll just call him out, and somebody will holler at him, say, hey, get over and out of the way.
Yeah, we have that problem a lot in baseball and softball. Appreciate these boys, but sometimes they shade, and they do start shading towards seconds we get in our field.
There's his called strike, and even it up at 2-2. Tincher catching up with him. This Lee County team's coached by Jason, at Osborne, I believe, and he's known for his baseball prowess and definitely going to try to return this Lee County team, who's won a 14th regional championship before, bring him back to that level again. Sure he will. Here comes Tincher with the 3-2. Just a little high, so looks like Shelton goes to first. All right. As soon as I can see, I apologize for not knowing these Lee County fellas like I do the Breathitt boys. Always disclaimer it, my son plays for Breathitt, so I'm trying to keep it as straight as I can, which I always do. Dalton Peters. Dalton will be up next, and I'll get you some positions in the next couple innings or two. There's a quick strike by Tincher to start out early. Sheldon's got a small lead there at first. Quick fastball there for early 0-2 lead on this, on Peters. Oh, here we go. I'm getting my paperwork all together. Swing and a miss. Three straight pitches and three straight strikes. All right. Peter's an eighth grader. Matt, I didn't realize that, so I wouldn't have said that by looking at him. Good-looking kid.
All right. They're the senior leader up here now for Lee County.
Yeah, I'm trying to see what numbers is it. Is that?
That's Bryce Angel.
Okay. Yep. Number 3, Bryce Angel, senior leader. There we go. Look at some stats here. Yeah. Played most of the games this year. Looks like he missed a couple. Batting 250 for the year. And some of these stats are not updated. I noticed Breathitt's weren't completely updated for this week. So Tincher's got him 0-1. A little bit high.
That's the thing with baseball, you know, it comes at you so much quicker than football and basketball. You know, you might have, like I said, this week, 4 or 5 games. It's kind of hard to keep the stats up to date on the website.
Absolutely. Good observation. That's why you make the big bucks, Matt.
That'd be nice.
Yep. There goes Shelton. Shelton's going. There's the throw to second. Oh, and he backed out of it. Comes Bellamy, throw him, and tags him out at first. Kind of got out of position. Now, that's one of those chances where it's, if you go far enough, you might as well just go on. But he's fleet of feet. But they got him for the second out of the inning.
I've lost track of the ball strike count here on. I didn't know if that was a ball or strike. They called the last one on Angel.
I want to say it was a ball. I was kind of watching the runner. And it doesn't help to have a big sheet of plywood in front of you when you're looking.
Yeah, at well, you try to shift over here.
No, I'm good. You're more important than I am, my man. I'm just talking.
I couldn't move the camera. Trying to get back in rhythm.
Good cut by Angel. Fouls it off straight back. And that'll make it 1-2. So Tincher with a quick walk. Could get out of the top of the first here if he get one past Angel. Well, hope everybody's enjoying this beautiful day out here. Just a little bit low. I've been to Louisville and back today, Matt, and it was a beautiful day to drive. So if I fall asleep at some point in time today on this, just nudge me and keep me going. I'm old.
Gotcha. Put you on the camera.
And Tincher lost him. It was 3-2, high and inside on that last pitch, and Angel pulls a walk just like Shelton did. So Lee County's got a runner on first with two outs, top of the first, and that looks like number 8, Timothy Tipton. Sorry, Tim. Tim's a sophomore.
Yeah, and Angel moves to second. Angel, on my
pitch. But while I'm writing Tim Tipton's name down, there goes Angel. So he's so fast, I didn't even see him. Comes Tincher with a hot fastball right down the middle, 1-1. I go to church with Isaac Bellamy there at second. That Angel's bigger than he is. Bellamy's a big old boy. That's pretty impressive. Me being the short man that I am, you know, always enjoying someone with height. Jealous, I guess, is what the word is. I've always been vertically challenged. And there's a shot to third. Bash Howard at third throws it over to first. And Hudson catches the ball and gets him out for the third in, out of the inning. So looks like Lee County strands one on a couple walks. Tincher, no runs in the top of the first. So we'll go to a break and here at the middle of the inning and be right back with the bottom of the inning. Breathitt up and score 0-0. This is BSN.
Kentucky Farm Bureau agents wear a lot of hats. They're coaches, volunteers, church members, neighbors, someone who's there when you need them, especially when you need them most. That may be a lot of hats, but they're all the perfect fit. Kentucky Farm Bureau, big on commitment.
YPK Motorsports is excited to help you experience the fun and adventure a quality Yamaha, Polaris, or Kawasaki vehicle can bring to your life. Now with four locations, YPK invites you to see our great selection of ATVs, side-by-sides, dirt bikes, and more. Come visit us in Jackson, Hazard, or Paintsville, or online at ypkmotorsports.com.
At HCTC, you're more than just a student.
I am motivated.
I am retired.
I am a grandmother.
I am a veteran.
I am an entrepreneur.
I am a son.
I am a small business owner.
I am HCTC.
Jackson Physical Therapy is your locally owned and operated physical therapy clinic, serving Jackson and the surrounding areas. Owned by Colby Watts, Jackson Physical Therapy has a talented and experienced staff ready to meet all your physical therapy needs. Jackson Physical Therapy is a proud supporter of our local youth and sports teams. Call JPT at 666-9293 to schedule your appointment today and let us improve your quality of life.
Hey, everybody, welcome back. Breathitt County Field, Breathitt County Bobcats, and Lee County Bobcats going at it here. Bottom of the first, just getting going if you're joining us. And just want to say thanks to those sponsors. You saw Jackson Physical Therapy and Colby Watts. YPK Motorsports, we appreciate you guys helping bring this to the people. Couldn't do it without you.
I think you forgot one I played there.
Did I miss it?
Yeah, that first one there.
First one was...
Something about Farm Bureau.
Breathitt County Farm Bureau. They're not much. I heard they rip 4 girls that work in that office that are really good, but the guys, not much. All right, kids. Lee County's bringing Jesse Drake, a junior, out to the mound to face Isaac Bellamy here in the bottom of the first. And one right in the eyes. 2-0 to Bellamy. Bellamy started off, just to give people information, started off a little slow, had an injury this year. You can see the sleeve on his arm, and he's been working through that, trying to get healthy again. This is Jesse's, looks like this is Jesse's third game. So he's just getting into it. Bryce Angel's their number one pitcher, it looks like, with the most games at least. And looks like, and as I was looking at my notes, looks like they threw it wild for the fourth strike, or the fourth ball. Now I'm watching them run the bases, man. There we go. So let me recap what just happened as I was writing down notes. Looks like Bellamy got a walk. And on that walk, when he went to first, the ball got away from the catcher. So he ran to second, and the throw to second was a little errant. And on the throw, that ball went into center, and Bellamy ran to third. So essentially, Bellamy got a triple walk on that. And Coach Osborne is absolutely not happy. Just don't even change that camera, Matt, like you don't do for an injury. You don't want to put it out there because hearts are getting stepped on right now. Oh, I enjoy his fire.
That's good. All right. Hold him accountable.
Well, you know, when you get in an early game like this and you got jitters and things like that and you're trying to make a play, daggone it, they just threw the ball around a little bit. They'll settle down. This Lee team's young, but I remember I went to the game in Lee County and they did just fine for me. So Brady Tencher, number two, looks like the pitcher's up now for the Bobcats with Bellamy on third, no outs. And he saw something he liked with that pitch, but just missed it. 1-1. Stepped back with a smile on his face, and knowing that he probably tried just a little too hard to hit that one. All right, Drake looking in, throws one, and looks like Tencher got all that one off the reservation. So far in left field, and Tencher puts one in Pambo Lake. Bellamy scores. Tencher rounds third.
Mr. Brady Tencher.
So that'll make it 2-0 Breathitt. Bottom of the first.
Number 52, Mr. Robbie Turner.
Drake might have held that. Put that one in the wrong spot. Teacher's known this is his first one of the year that I can remember.
He hit multiple last year. Yeah, I think his first one is this year for him.
Yeah. So here's Robbie Turner, senior, another senior. We've had 3 seniors to bat for Breathitt so far. Robbie's catching for the Bobcats, the Breathitt Bobcats. I'm going to have to not say that tonight. I'm going to mess everybody up. Well, that's an easy way to get out of trouble. The Bobcats did that. The Bobcats did this.
I promise they did.
Well, Drake fires in. He's two balls, no strikes. It's got to shake a man's nerve a little bit. See if the young man can gather himself. Good looking pitching for him. 3-0. So if you're just joining us, it's 2-0. Breathitt, bottom of the first. This is the third batter of the inning, Robbie Turner. And walks him on 4 pitches.
Up next, number 34, Mr. Bash Howard.
So if you can hear the press announcer, I'm not going to even talk. Bash Howard steps up. Bash is shortstop for Breathitt tonight. He's a sophomore. And probably, if I look through their stats, one of their higher, yes, but he is the highest average hitter for the Bobcats, for the Breathitt Bobcats. 472, Matt. That'll get the job done. Turner takes his lead at first. It's pitched by Drake. They're keeping Robbie on there pretty tight.
The wind is swirling hard out there in center field. My camera keeps getting moved around, so I'm not really sure how good a view we have from that center field camera.
Looks like the umpire is talking to the pitcher a little bit. He might have had maybe a little misstep when he was delivering that. It's nice of him to give him a quote-unquote warning for a balk or something like that. No sense doing that the first time. His kids are all learning. Yeah, Bash Howard, a sophomore, got a couple more years left on the diamond, at least here. Heard that he's getting some recruiting looks already. High pitch, and Turner goes to second. It's going to be close, and he makes it in just fine. Oh, looks like they've snuck a runner on us while we were talking about it, Matt. Is that Adam Spencer? Okay. Thanks, everybody, for telling the old man who can't see. I said last time that I was on BSN that I'd get some glasses, and I actually did ask about that. So maybe here in a week or two I have some glasses and I can see some people better. Somebody can help me down the steps when I leave, okay? Oh, man. And Bash pulls a walk as well.
Next, number 24, Mr. 8 Combs.
And this week I brought a pencil, which is nice. It'll help me keep score. And I've got Breathitt. I'm doing so much better, Matt. I already had one team's listings and brought a pencil. So, man, I'm making progress in my second game calling. So here's Big Aiden Combs, eighth grader. Runners on first and second, Howard and Adam Spencer, who's pinch running for catcher Robbie Turner. There's a little quick strike. So Drake gets ahead of Aiden. Aiden, though the eighth grader, is average-wise still batting 300, so he's doing well. And there's a hot shot foul down towards Coach Combs on third. Yeah, I got a shout-out, man. I'm sitting here looking. I thought these might have been by. I guess they are for the most part. Looks like the highest hitter for Breathitt is John Thomas Price. He's batting 500 this year. But that's two at-bats, so let's not. I'm just throwing one out for the boy there, being sarcastic. He had a real nice strikeout in the JV game the other night that I chastised him about for a week, for about 24 hours now. So pretty strikeout. He's got a pretty swing. All right, here's the 1-2 to Combs. Oh, a little grazing blow to the solar plexus. So he'll be HBP, hit by a pitch. And that will load him up for Mr. Kobe Bird. Kobe's DH'ing tonight for the Bobcats. Been a solid performer all year, putting the bat on the ball. A little curveball for a strike. Bases are loaded. Bottom of the first. Breathitt Bobcats up 2-0. And no outs. And Kobe takes one in the back of the head. Did that hit him in the back of the head?
Back of the head.
Back of the head. That's why you wear helmets, folks. We've seen it before. Sure, I'll see it again. That brings in Robbie Turner, or Adam Spencer. I got to give Adam credit there. Sorry about that, Adam. So that makes it 3-0, Breathitt County. And lefty Danny Cayton comes up to bat. Danny's playing right field tonight. Another sophomore for Breathitt. Nice cut by Caton. Kobe Bird on first. Aiden Combs on second. Bash Howard on third for Breathitt. Yeah, Breathitt has a lot of sophomores, not many juniors. Juniors aren't very good. I'm just kidding. I've got one in here with me, my buddy Chase Hobbs, who's fighting out an injury, and maybe we'll talk to Chase a little bit tonight. 11, well, here on the BSN. But. And as I was talking to Chase, what happened? Did he hit him?
No, there was a hit by pit. Run, yes.
So Danny got hit as well. And here comes the crazy chants by the baseball team.
Because we're having a pitching change.
Yeah, Jesse is
number 14 for Lee County will be on the mound.
That's Cash Harold, freshman. So Drake, the junior, steps out first inning. He gave up that two-run homer, and it kind of got him off on the wrong foot. Didn't recover from that. So, but hopefully that's a good learning experience for that young man. He'll come back stronger the next game.
And we're going to sneak in a quick commercial break.
Absolutely.
While he's getting warmed up. We'll be back here in about 1 minute on Bluegrass Sports Nation.
Jackson Electric and Plumbing Supply in Jackson, Kentucky is proud to serve Breathitt, Lee, Wolf, Morgan, Owsley, Perry, and Madison counties. Established in 1982 with over 40 years of service to those communities, Jackson Electric and Plumbing Supply can not only meet your electric and plumbing needs, but also heating and cooling, concrete and metal septic tanks, as well as your special orders. Call Scott and the gang today at 606-666-4052.
Variety Pizza, located at 1189 Main Street in Jackson, has been family-owned and operated for over 45 years, serving the community with fresh, homemade, and handcrafted pizzas, sandwiches, salads, and more. Carry out or stay and enjoy the newly renovated dining areas with private party spaces available. Stop by and see Lee and Al or call 666-5454 for Variety Pizza. Family and Hometown Pharmacies have been serving Breathitt County for over 20 years and are proud to support our local athletes. They are hometown owned and operated by Portia and Everett Dunaway. Portia and Everett want you to know that Family and Hometown Pharmacies are here for you. Now offering two ways to fill your prescriptions. Use the Refill Quick app on your smartphone or give them a call at 666-5519 or 666-5500.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the Breathitt County Bobcats, Lee County Bobcats game. Here from Jackson, and we're in the bottom of the first, and got a quick pitch and change. Cash Harold, the freshman from Lee County, is coming in to throw. And throwing to Jaden Hudson. Jaden's playing first tonight. Had a little injury for our normal first baseman, Mr. Reese Cox, but hopefully he'll be back in a few days.
I mean, that's in a quick 0-2 hole.
He's coming out and throwing some strikes. Got a different little delivery. Kind of hesitates that delivery. Sometimes that'll throw a batter off, hesitate that pitch, and I think it'll take some time to get used to that. Interesting. Coming from the stretch. A little bit sidearm, too, and there's a shot down the left right field line. Foul ball. So Hudson's getting him dialed in a little, getting used to it. Hudson, another eighth grader on this team. We've got a bunch of eighth graders, a bunch of freshmen to play. Future is bright in Breathitt County for baseball. Lee County as well. So far, we've seen a bunch of young kids. That's good. So bases loaded to Breathitt County Bobcats, and Jaden fouls one back. Call him out. Aiden Combs on third. Colby Bird on second. And Mr. Danny Caton, the Bolivian Bomber, on first. Great story. I'm friends with his mom and dad. And his mother's from Bolivia. Super lady. Dad's not bad, too. A little bit high. So he's worked at 2-2. Still no outs. Breathitt up 4-0 in the bottom of the first. Sure appreciate all those sponsors again. Jackson Electric, we saw during that last commercial run. Variety Pizza, made me hungry watching the commercial. Family Pharmacy, the place where I get my cholesterol medicine, just in case that I do eat a pizza. So I do eat a piece of pizza. I get my cholesterol medicine there. Everett and Portia. Everett and Portia has been there for a long time. Did a really fine job. We appreciate you guys sponsoring baseball tonight. Here we are, 2-2 to the Hudson. And he pops that one up right around, looks like third baseman, shortstop going for it, and the third baseman picks it up. That was, yeah, Dalton Peters. We saw on the top of the first, Dalton playing third base. So that's the first out for Breathitt. I'm going to fill in some of these positions while I'm working. And here comes another senior, Mr. Dylan Stacy. So everybody stays on the bases. Dylan's up with one out. Dylan playing center field. Young man is very fleet of feet and will run down any kind of ball that gets out outfield. Solid performer on defense. A little bit high, 2-0. Big Cash Herald pitching for the Lee County Bobcats. Throws one in, Dylan hits it to right field, out of view. Looks like it got down in front of the right fielder. He throws it into second and score one. So a single for Dylan Stacy. Next, number 8, Mr. Isaac Bellamy. So here we are, back to the top of the lineup, Isaac Bellamy. Isaac took a walk his first at bat a few minutes ago. And now he comes to the plate with the bases loaded. Bird, Kayton, and Stacy loops one out between the right fielder and center fielder. Center fielder grabs it, throws it in. Looks like it's going to be a double, bringing in 2-3, clearing the bases for the Bobcats. So Bellamy brings up a double. I'm riding as fast as I can. I'm breaking the lead. So 8-0. Bobcats have come out to play tonight. So Brady Tincher's coming up, and if you don't remember, he put one into Pambo Lake first at bat down the left field. And we'll see how he does the second at bat. Tincher batting 378 for the season as of last week. As we said, his first home run of the season. Just in the top of the inning, or the bottom of the inning, if you want to say it that way. Cash Herald bringing it in for the Lee County Bobcats. Just a bit outside. That's 2-1 to Tincher. Isaac Bellamy on second after hitting a quick double into right center, cleaning the bases for the Breathitt team. Tincher ropes one to center field, and that might bring Bellamy in. He does, and they throw it to second to hold Tincher to a single, but it's still an RBI. It's 3 RBIs for Tincher tonight, and here comes Robbie Turner. Hope everybody's enjoying the music. Did I get a smile from the PA director, Kara Cox? Got to give a shout out to my number one fan out there tonight. I've only got two, my wife and Kendra Fisher. Hi, Kendra, making cinnamon rolls at home tonight.
Yeah. Oatmeal cream pie,
oh,
sir.
Oh, sorry. It doesn't matter what she makes. It's
going to be delicious.
There's one section on my body that has fat on it. My whole body has fat on it. But there's one section that has just Kendra Fisher fat from the food that she makes. She's so good. Her and her dad, Tommy Miller. There's a shot to Angel at short. And tried to catch Tincher on third, but he couldn't get there in time. Tincher outran him. He had a head start. And that's not fair. So the fielder's choice puts him on. That was Robbie getting a fielder's choice single, and Tincher moves over to third. Good try by Angel there. Here's Bash Howard, cleanup batter. Last time he walked. 9-0. Breathitt County Bobcats, bottom of the first. And Bash loops one into left field. I don't think it has enough to get out of here. Oh, but it outruns the left fielder, and he's against the fence, so he brings it in. There comes Tincher to score. Looks like it's going to move pinch runner Adam Spencer again that we didn't see come in to third. And that'll be a double for Bash Howard. It's a long, strange trip. It's all insane. You ain't never gonna be the same. I think Robbie's gonna be mad. Like Cole, my son Cole gets pinched. When he pitches, they pinch run for him, and he comes off the field, and he's like, "They never let me run." Robbie's, they took him out twice tonight. I keep looking for him on the bases, and they put Adam in. So, but catching's tough. When you catch, man, you gotta have stamina and endurance to be a catcher. Robbie does. Robbie does a great job. So they're going to save those legs for squatting instead of running. Here's Aiden Combs again. Shows a bunt, and it's a suicide squeeze. Adam Spencer scores from third, and they throw out Combs on the sacrifice.
Number three, Mr. Colby Bird.
They also moved Howard over to third, put him in even closer scoring position. So 11 to nothing. 1, 2, 3. 11-0. Makes it 11-0. That's two. The second out, though, for the Bogans. And Bird absolutely rips one to center. He's rounding second. That'll score Bash. So Colby gets in on the fun and hits a double to center.
The sun going up and down here. This cloud is really messing with my camera.
Well, we got a big shadow, too. I hope that people will help us overlook that little shadow on the infield. The Lord says it's time to go to sleep, so he's putting the sun down for us.
We don't have a problem, but the wind took my outfield camera and turned it left.
Oh, it did?
Yeah.
I could probably text somebody and tell them to move it if you want me to.
Yeah, it's all right. We will go with it. That's the big difficulty with baseball. You know, it's a lot different than any other sport.
Well, did anybody just message in on BSN there and tell us if you ever want us to show you a pretty view of the lake and ducks and some of the Canadian geese that tend to take up positions here in the infield and the outfield of the baseball field. They'll be down there in the lake. It's hard not to call it a river, just for those that don't know. Pambo Lake was a man-made lake. It used to be the Kentucky River in days before I was here on this earth, and the Kentucky Corps of Engineers dammed it off and made it a lake. And one time, it was one of the better fishing lakes in the state of Kentucky. I don't know what... I don't fish much. I don't have the patience for fishing, but I don't know how the fish are. Feel free, if you fish, to tell us on BSN there on the message board. Here's Kayton. Harold's trying to get through this inning. Throws a strike right down the middle. Puts him into the dugout for strike three and out number three. But the Bobcats strand one, but have plated 12 in the bottom of the first. We'll go to the top of the second. The Breathitt Bobcats up 12-0. Lee County coming up the second bat. This is BSN.
Basketball fans know December is the start of the holiday season. a four-month round ball holiday running all winter right through March. And at Rose Brothers, we're happy to help Bluegrass Sports Nation bring great high school action to you each week. And when your athletes need basketball shoes, or when you need warm weather gear to get through the winter, come see us at Rose Brothers. We have performance athletic footwear from Nike, Under Armour, and Skechers, and great outerwear from Columbia, Simply Southern, and Under Armour. Now let's cheer on our young athletes, and good luck from all of us at Rose Brothers in Jackson and Bainville.
PDQ Sales and Services, formerly known as Jackson Wholesale Company, is a locally owned and operated convenience store and grocery store supplier with a full line of products. They have ice cream, groceries, meat, dairy, candy, and more. They even have janitorial supplies, including Tactical Strike disinfectant. Tactical Strike has been approved by the EPA to kill the virus that causes COVID-19. Give PDQ a call today at 606-666-2495.
Since 1962, Citizens Bank and Trust of Jackson has been proud to serve the community. They care about the people of Breathitt County and are the only locally owned bank in the community. With two branches in Jackson and one in Beattyville, they're never too far away when you need them. And with the latest innovations in banking, keeping track of your finances has never been easier. Helping to grow Breathitt County as leaders for over 60 years. That's Citizens Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Breathitt County High School Baseball Field. Breathitt County Bobcats, Lee County Bobcats. And if you can hear me over the great music that they're playing to get these kids fired up for this top of the second. Breathitt County came out with the bats on fire in the bottom of the first and played to 12 runs. So an early 12-0 lead for Breathitt. And we'll try to work through here. And fans, this is just my second game calling these, and I sure appreciate everybody's patience with me and doing this. I've had a pretty fun time doing it. And I thought I had two fans, but, man, I've got three now. So, Susan Kincaid, big hugs and kisses from the boss. You're my favorite. She's listening to me. Whoa, there's one right back at us. She's listening to me, and her son doesn't even play. So, Kincaid's are great family friends from Lee County. And really think a lot of that much. So, to bat here, this is big Jake Jewell. Jake's a freshman. I like his hair. I always love hair because I have none. There he goes, sends one out to center field for the first hit for Lee County tonight. Nice bit of hitting. Jaden Hudson, the Bobcats, changed pitchers. They started out with Brady Tencher pitching the first inning, and he walked a couple but got out of it. And now Jaden Hudson, we got another eighth grader. Jaden's eighth grader. So we got some young players getting to see some more time tonight. So Jake puts one out in the center, so Lee County's got something going here. No outs, top of the second. And this looks like number five, Jake Mays. Oh, and he threw to first, quick throw to first. Looks like Jake got back. Trying to get everybody down. So Jake Jewell on first, and this and Jake Mays, the eighth grader, they throw down to first again. Brady Tencher's mad about something. He's throwing, trying to get him every time. I guess that's the point of the game, isn't it? But Jewell got back in time. I know this Jake Mays kid. Another good family from Lee County. Got Jake Jewell and Jake Mays right behind each other. Lee County has their numbers in. Down on the lower left side, and it's tough to see him. Mays tries to bunt, bunts foul, trying to move Jewell over. That'll make it 1-2. So, after giving up a hit, first at bat, looks like Hudson's up on the count, 1-2. See if he can get Mays here. Mays trying to get a little momentum going for Lee County. He's still in it. Fouled off. Tincher couldn't get it, hit the fence, so we'll stay at 1-2. It's just going to be me for a few minutes, folks. Matt's gone out to fix the camera. This might be a good time to talk to some of the injured Bobcats that are sitting up here with us. What about it, Chase Hayes? You want to come talk about your knee injury? Come on over. It looks like while we were talking to him, May struck out. So we got a lefty here, so that'll help me tell you who he is. Xavier Martin, eighth grader. So far, Breathitt and Lee both have a lefty hitting. You gonna come talk to me, Chase? One. It's just me and you, buddy. So Xavier's 1-1. Everybody say hi to Chase Hayes. Chase, how are you doing tonight, buddy? A long day. Well, you know, your school. Tell everybody about yourself. Are you a junior? Yep. And just played baseball. How many years have you played baseball? 7 years. What happened to you this year? Tore what?
MCL.
An MCL. Oh, gosh. So he's rehabbing that for him. Matt's getting all the cameras worked up, and the boss is here, too. 2-2 to Martin. So, Chase, you're a junior. What are you going to do with your life after high school?
We go to EKU studying for marine biology.
Marine biology. Now, that's different. What are you going to do with that?
I try to get a job there.
Okay. Do some Department of Wildlife stuff, maybe? Or I know a buddy of mine. I was talking about Susan Kincaid there a minute ago. Her brother-in-law works I don't know if he works for the state, but he does that at Moorhead. He's the fish man. That's what we call him, the fish squeezer. And I'm trying to see what number that is. I think that is 14. That's Cash Harrell. That's the fella, young guy, started out the first of the inning there against Breathitt pitching, and they moved him out after a couple runs. Another freshman.
He's got a lot of pressure.
Yeah, we've seen, we've noted that there's a lot of youth on the field tonight. Here comes Hudson, another youth. There's a shot to third base. Looks like Howard's going to throw it to first for the third out of the inning. So it looks like Lee County Strand's one. And we're going to go to the middle. And I don't know. Oh, Matt's ready. Matt's ready to go. So we're going to go to commercial. Thanks, Chase Hayes, for stepping in for a second. If y'all see Chase out in public, pat him on the back. I know that's tough, have an injury and not get to play. So good, best of luck to you, my buddy. All right, we'll be right back in the middle of the inning. It's 12-0, Breathitt County. This is BSN.
During a loss, we realize that your loved one is your most valuable possession. At Breathitt Funeral Home, we consider it an honor to serve your family. We've recently made some big changes, but not only to the building. We have lowered our prices to what we believe are the lowest in Breathitt County. We offer payment plans for prearranged funerals, and we will honor prearrangements from any other funeral home. Breathitt Funeral Home, premium service at an affordable price, when only the best will do.
Come see us at Jackson Medical Clinic Family Healthcare in Jackson for all your medical needs. Now also offering behavioral healthcare services. The clinic is open 7 days a week and will have new extended hours of operation beginning on January 1st, 2024. Hours of operation will be from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. Monday through Thursday and 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Saturday and Sunday. With a hometown atmosphere, come let our family take care of yours.
All right, guys, we're back. Bottom of the second. An early 12-0 lead for Breathitt County over Lee County. Lee made a little noise there in the top of the second. Didn't get anybody across to home. And here comes Jaden Hudson, who's in the pitch now for the Bobcats to bat. And thanks to Kentucky Fish and Wildlife for giving us some information.
Yeah, Matthew Johnson says at Fish and Wildlife.
Thank you, Matt. We said there's some... still some big fish in Pambo Lake. So if you want a good day out fishing, Jackson's where you need to go. I'm going to change my score sheet. Hudson fouls one straight back. Watch out for car windows.
He did get a little put a little extra in at the LA last week. It was when a Hazards boys fouled one straight back onto a silver Ford. Didn't do the windshield and the top of the car a very good favor.
No, I don't like to see that. Do not like to see that. Well, our buddy Cash Harold's in pitching for the Lee County again. Just a bit outside. It's 2-1 to Hudson. No outs, bottom of the second, looking to get something started. There's a shot to left, popped up. It's going to be caught by the left fielder. I can't see his number. I am so sorry.
Double zero?
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It looked like a double zero, but I wasn't going to say it, but yep. That would be Cole Wilder. Good catch, Cole.
Cole Wilder is the cameraman for Lee County Basketball for BSN.
There you go. Cole's a sophomore in Lee County. Nice play. Here's another chance, but he is not going to get to that one. That's a shot by Dylan Stacy down the line. He's going to get into second, standing up. That'll bring Breathitt back to the top of the lineup. It's nice when your last batter can hit a double like that and then go to your leadoff again. So Dylan puts a shot into left field for a double with one out. Puts Breathitt back in scoring position here in the bottom of the second with a 12-0 lead. Senior Isaac Bellamy. This is already his third at bat. He walked and then he had a double in the bottom part of the first inning. Dylan is scaring him to death. He's got a lead big enough. Looks like he's getting ready to rob a bank. He is fleet of feet. I am jealous. I'm trying to listen to myself talk, Matt, and I'm trying to listen to these kids down here in the scoring booth listen to what I say and commenting on it. There's Bellamy with a shot into the left center. In between the outfielders, that's going to be trouble. Dylan strolls in for the run. Looks like Bellamy's got it full blast to third and going to, whoa, he should have slid, but he got by him anyway. And he's in with a triple. Big hit by Bellamy. That'll make her 13-0. And big bad Brady Tincher steps up. Brady already with a single and a home run tonight. I'm hearing names called out that I have no idea what they're talking about.
Wooly Swole. I'm not really.
I don't know what that means. I'm too old for that. I called him Big Bad Brady Tincher. That's all I knew.
Bam.
Oh, something to do with Charlie Daniels, man. That's something music that I didn't know about. There's one skyrocketing to third, and Tincher is
next number
out.
52, Mr. Robbie Tung.
Mr. Third Baseman, give me that number. It's Dalton Peters at third. Good play. That was a mile high. So here comes senior Robbie Turner. He's walked and got on a fielder's choice. In the first, looking to cause some damage. I think if he gets on, we're going to holler down there and say, let him run, because they took him out both times running.
Come on,
Bellamy takes a small lead at third. Ball outside, 2-0 to Robbie. Just want to comment on this Lee County team. Even though the score is what it is, I'm watching them out in the field, and defensively they're doing everything they need to do. You know, the little movements, they're getting ready. You can tell they're well coached. It's just this youth and Breathitt with five seniors is just going to take its toll on them tonight. But Better watch out for this Lee County team in the future. Robbie reaches out and smacks one to left. And with the wind playing tricks with it, and he's still. What was it? Who was that?
Left fielder.
Peter, is it?
Cole Wilder.
Wilder, yep, yep. Cole Wilder, double zero. Great play. Two good plays by Cole Wilder there and in the bottom of the second. So as we go to commercial, Breathitt 13, Lee 0. We'll be right back. BSN.
What keeps you going? Your love for the game? Your teammates? A victory? At ARH Orthopedics, our goal is to keep you pain-free so your body can keep going. There's no time for discomfort in your joints or ligaments caused by an injury. ARH Orthopedic providers specialize in treatment plans from non-surgical and surgical options, so your care is entirely centered around you. Visit arh.org/ortho to find an orthopedic provider near you. ARH, more for Appalachia.
Wolf County is widely known as a rock climbing and hiking destination, but is now quickly becoming known for its great restaurants and entertainment venues. Venues like Skybridge Station, where you can see live music on the weekends or go to Tuesday Night Trivia. Kell's Patriot Pizza, Spanks Franks, Dixie Freeze, E. Finca, 145 Steakout, which has live music most weekends, The Brick, Red Point Barbecue, and Bites and Bargains. Wolf County is naturally gorgeous, and Wolf County Tourism invites you to stop in and try one of these great restaurants on your next visit.
Appalachian Wireless is all in on tech madness right now. Select devices get up to $500 off on the Appalachian Advantage Unlimited or nationwide mix and match plans with renewed or new lines. Plus, use a trade-in for additional savings of up to $250 for a possible savings of up to $750. See AppalachianWireless.com for complete terms and conditions. It's tech madness with up to $750 off because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Go Time is a locally owned and operated convenience store that has all your wants and needs in one stop. We have everything from quick snacks and cool drinks, a full-service deli, fresh coffee bar, soft-serve ice cream, and milkshakes. Also, make sure to check out our Little Caesars pizzas. Go Time, where the customer always comes first. Refuel your tank, refill your cup, and refresh your taste buds all in one stop at Go Time.
Kentucky Farm Bureau agents wear a lot of hats. They're coaches, volunteers, church members, neighbors, someone who's there when you need them, especially when you need them most. That may be a lot of hats, but they're all the perfect fit. Kentucky Farm Bureau, big on commitment.
Welcome back, everybody. Here we are in Breathitt County, top of the third, Lee County Bobcats, Breathitt County Bobcats. And it's been all Breathitt so far. And we've had three innings and three pitchers for Breathitt. They're moving some youth around. And it looks like Tatum Moore. I think Tatum's a seventh grader. So he's going to pitch.
He's a seventh grader?
Yes, sir.
That's a great big old seventh grader.
Yeah, he's tall. Good baseball player. Strong. Works out. All right, we're going to come here to Lee County. Looks like boy Cole Wilder is going to be up to bat. He's the ninth batter. Cole's playing some good defense tonight. Made some good catches and left. Top of the third. What are we doing? Everybody's looking around. No, we have no umpires. That means they're talking to Coach Osborne about something. Can't see their numbers, much less read lips that far away. So, like Jacoby Little has moved into the catcher position for the Cats. Catches Tatum a little bit. Going to see some new people. Somebody's at second. Is that Adam Spencer at second? Maybe.
Still got Bash at third. Is that Aiden at short now?
Maybe. Yep. It's Aiden Combs. Well, while the umpires are working out whatever issues they have, we just want to say thanks again to those sponsors. That last run, we saw ARH Medical, Appalachian Wireless, Wolf County Tourism. If you've not been to Wolf County and seen the beautiful trails and scenery of Wolf County, you're missing out, folks. Spend some time doing that. The food is really good, too. And I'll tell you what, I know food. And it is good. And speaking of food, Go Time, thanks to their sponsorship. A couple different stores, a lot of different stores in Eastern Kentucky.
Eight. They're eight up to eight stores. Different locations. Wow.
We always try to stop at those whenever we're traveling. We stopped in Corbin the other day, and we tried to give our money to them because they're a sponsor on BSN. We thank you all and all those other ones, even Farm Bureau. We thank them for helping out with bringing you this baseball tonight. Cole Wilder gets the first pitch from Moore, and it was a – I missed it.
The ball in the dirt.
It's a ball in the dirt. That will not be a strike.
I forgot to change my innings. I'm sorry, guy.
Good. There's a strike. Wilder tried to put that one in right field. Missed it. 1-1. Top of the third. 13-0. So, theoretically, if high school they have, I guess the rule is 15 runs after three.
Is it 15 after three and 10 after five?
10 after five, just in case. Oh, and Moore puts one right between the zeros and Wilder's back. Hit by pitch. Feel that tomorrow. We've seen a lot of hit batsmen tonight. Just if they were listening to our broadcast, they might throw some up here at us, too. One, two, three. That's the fourth one tonight. So back to the top of the lineup for Lee County, Mr. Landon Shelton. Last time Landon walked and got picked off trying to steal. Wilder takes a good lead at first. There's a strike. Matt, I always like to say, you know, I know this Breathitt team because, you know, my boys play, my two younger boys play, and I've seen them, watched them all spring and things like that. And I enjoy getting to see some of these other teams like Lee County. Last game we got to watch Hazard play, and they when they beat Breathitt in All-A. It's there's some good baseball played in Eastern Kentucky, guys. I enjoy watching, learning some of these kids' names. Maybe we'll do it again next year if y'all don't throw me off for some reason.
We enjoy having you, Chuck, that's for sure.
Well, this makes it fun. Otherwise, I'd be just sitting there talking to my wife, and I do that all the time anyway, so she doesn't miss me. Tried to frame that one, little did, and didn't get the call. So 2-2. And we apologize for the wire mesh in front of the camera up here, guys. It's for Matt's protection. Don't want to hurt his pretty face on a foul ball.
That being said, last year we pulled that mesh back.
Oh.
And just went around it. But I think we're going to try to work out a deal and cut just a small square out and we get a clearer view.
All right. See, I get things done here. Second day out and I'm getting stuff done. Tatum steps off the rubber and makes Wilder go back to first. And resets for the pitch. 3-2, full count. I'd say Wilder might take off on this one. Going to be a little aggressive. And there didn't foul ball right at Coach Osborne. Didn't even move. Steely stands. I think he's a little hot. He's gotten on the troops a little hard a couple times here tonight. And it's I understand. This is a great learning experience for this bunch. Ooh. I guess we'll be coming up. Regional tournament will start sometime in May. So we got, what, about another month left of baseball season before we start getting into district and regional tournaments. Don't worry, BSN will try to bring you every single pitch that we can.
That's what we were talking about the other day. You know, we have quite a big support staff during the basketball season and even football. Baseball seems like our smallest staff right now. We're trying to get it bigger and trying to find people out there willing to come help call these games to bring more action to you on BSN.
And while Matt says that, Dalton Peters smacks one down the third base line for a single. Moves Wilder over to second, and Lee County is in business here at the top of the third. Sorry, Dalton, didn't get to call you out there, but that's a great hit. Dalton Peters, another eighth grader. And here's Big Bryce Angel. He has a look of vengeance in his eyes. He wants to get some runs on the board for Lee County. I can see it. So runners on first and second. Wilder at second. Shelton on first. And here's the pitch, a little bit high. And if you're out there listening, you have a business and would like to get in on all this action, bringing this high school baseball to the folks out there that can't get out or been working all day and are just sitting around at home and want to watch some good baseball, and BSN's where it's at, and you just reach out to Matt, and I'm sure he'll get you set up to get added to the sponsor list. The more the merrier, the more we can do. Good cut by Angel. Just missed it. Two strikes. One out. I say that a lot, and I keep forgetting that we actually have that on the screen now.
That's always good. I forget to change some things sometimes.
Well, man, that right there is a great example. You know, I was talking about sponsorship and things like that. The more people we have putting money in helping this, the more things we can do. I remember in the past, we just had a picture, and then kind of evolved to having a score because that money coming in, Brendan can get more things put on here as far as graphics. And now we've got strikes, balls, top of the third. They throw it down to third. The ball got away from the catcher, threw it to third, and it couldn't see the call. Looks like he's out. Called him out.
So the runner advances to second, but the runner at third is out.
So Cody Wilder out at third. Jacoby Little pulled that cannon out of his sleeve and fired it to third, got him out. That'll leave Shelton there, leave Peters in second, and Angel gets a walk from Moore, so he'll go fill that position again. So runners in first and second, two outs. Moore battling, trying to get through this inning. More good experience for young pitchers, young baseball players for this Breathitt County team. Peters is almost a third of the way to third. That lead, they're not really holding him.
Yeah, the picture's shaking a little bit, guys. Sorry, the more the wind picks up in center field, the more shake the camera's going to have.
That is us, not you. And there goes, he almost looked, but I don't know if y'all could see that on the screen. That was pretty good. Peters looked like he was stealing third, and Moore just looked at him, made him stop. Oh, man. It's pretty impressive. The young man didn't balk. Now he pulls over and throws back to second. Close play, but he's safe. That umpire out there in second is having a rough time. The sun's right in his eyes. He's having to shield himself the whole time. It's going to affect his visual perception. Them big words. Uh-oh, there goes. Oh, that cannon we talked about just threw one into left field by Little. And then there comes Angel to third, and he is going to be out.
Out.
That's the third out of the inning. So recap that. Peters was, he made it. Did he get credit for that run? He probably did.
He should have. He
crossed the plate. So we threw Peter. Jacoby jumped up and threw it, and he got away from Bash at third. Peters came around to score, but Angel got thrown out in the replay. Or not the replay, but the end of the play at third for the third out. So it should be one. So that'll make it 13-1. So Lee County does get on the board. And that'll leave Tipton up for the next inning, and we'll go to commercial. And we'll be right back here in the middle of the third inning. Breathitt County 13, Lee County 1. This is BSN.
YPK Motorsports is excited to help you experience the fun and adventure a quality Yamaha, Polaris, or Kawasaki vehicle can bring to your life. Now with four locations, YPK invites you to see our great selection of ATVs, side-by-sides, dirt bikes, and more. Come visit us in Jackson, Hazard, or Paintsville, or online at ypkmotorsports.com.
At HCTC, you're more than just a student.
I am motivated.
I am retired.
I am a grandmother.
I am a veteran.
I am an entrepreneur.
I am a son.
I am a small business owner.
I am HCTC.
Jackson Physical Therapy is your locally owned and operated physical therapy clinic, serving Jackson and the surrounding areas. Owned by Colby Watts, Jackson Physical Therapy has a talented and experienced staff ready to meet all your physical therapy needs. Jackson Physical Therapy is a proud supporter of our local youth and sports teams. Call JPT at 666-9293 to schedule your appointment today and let us improve your quality of life.
Welcome back to Breathitt County High School Field. Breathitt County Bobcats, Lee County Bobcats. We want to give a shout out to our buddy Reese Cox, who's a senior for Breathitt.
Mr. Caleb.
Was involved in a horrific car accident this week. Young man walked away from it. Just a little bit of a concussion, and we're just thank the Lord that he's here with us today. This baseball stuff's all fun and games, and at the end of the day, these kids are what it's all about. And there is that Bailey? Well, I'm sorry, Caleb. I missed you. He was talking about Reese there. But Caleb Bailey, freshman, gets a little shot to third.
Mr. JT Price.
Did he get on? Okay. Nope.
No, he was down that.
He didn't beat it out. Okay. So here's freshman John Thomas Price right over his head. Seen this kid a few times.
As the dust swirls.
His mommy's the prettiest woman in Breathitt County. Sorry, ladies. JT, he used to play a little travel ball, and then from what I hear, he's a real good golfer. So you'll see him out this summer hitting the little white ball instead of this big white ball. The one out was a 6-3 play for Bailey. Caleb Bailey, said freshman. Price fouls it back. 2-1. If you hear me scream at him, well, I won't scream at him. I promised my wife I wouldn't scream at him, so especially since I'm on the radio. Go, kid. There's a shot to third, same situation. Got under the glove, and he's going to make it to first. We'll call that a hit. We won't give him an error. That was a tough play by the third baseman and the shortstop right between them both. So, and my score sheet's just completely obliterated now because here's eighth grader Miles Holland. Somebody thinks they can sing. Funny how those songs have lasted the way they have. Pop up to second. Oh, we about had a collision. Angel ran into, that is number five, Jake Mates. Jake. And a good play by Jake, even with having Angel hanging all over him. That's a good play. So that'll leave John Thomas at first. Two outs. And Jake Fugit. Why am I calling Combs? Seventh grader Jake Combs. Fugit. Oh, sorry, Jake. I've done that twice. I got it. Jake's played a lot of baseball in his young, short life. He has a big future ahead. Tops that one up. And that's going to be in between the catcher and third baseman. The catcher comes out and makes the play. Good play by Tipton. Job. And that'll end the inning for the Bobcats. So as we go to the top of the fourth, Breathitt 13, Lee County 1. We'll be back in just a second. This is Bluegrass Sports Nation.
YPK Motorsports is excited to help you experience the fun and adventure a quality Yamaha, Polaris, or Kawasaki vehicle can bring to your life. Now with four locations, YPK invites you to see our great selection of ATVs, side-by-sides, dirt bikes, and more. Come visit us in Jackson, Hazard, or Paintsville, or online at ypkmotorsports.com.
At HCTC, you're more than just a student.
I am motivated.
I am retired.
I am a grandmother.
I am a veteran.
I am an entrepreneur.
I am a son.
I am a small business owner.
I am HCTC.
Jackson Physical Therapy is your locally owned and operated physical therapy clinic, serving Jackson and the surrounding areas. Owned by Colby Watts, Jackson Physical Therapy has a talented and experienced staff ready to meet all your physical therapy needs. Jackson Physical Therapy is a proud supporter of our local youth and sports teams. Call JPT at 666-9293 to schedule your appointment today and let us improve your quality of life.
Jackson Electric and Plumbing Supply in Jackson, Kentucky is proud to serve Breathitt, Lee, Wolf, Morgan, Owsley, Perry, and Madison counties. Established in 1982 with over 40 years of service to those communities, Jackson Electric and Plumbing Supply can not only meet your electric and plumbing needs, but also heating and cooling, concrete and metal septic tanks, as well as your special orders. Call Scott and the gang today at 606-666-4052.
Welcome back, folks. As we jam to Europe from 1986, I'm thinking. We're at the top of the fourth, reaching the final countdown of this game, 13-1 Breathitt. We've got a lot of young players coming in. We'll try to fill you in on those. Young man Tatum Moore still pitching. He pitched the third inning. He's going to pitch the fourth inning here for Breathitt County Bobcats as Tim Tipton steps up for Lee County. As they get ready and throw the ball around a little bit, just again, thanks so much to the sponsors, Citizens Bank, Rose Brothers, PDQ Services, former Jackson Wholesale, ARH, Appalachian Wireless, Wolf County Tourism, Go Time. Wow, you guys got a lot. Jackson Physical Therapy, YPK Motorsports, best place to buy an ATV that you can find, Jackson Electric, Variety Pizza, Family Pharmacy, and Hazard Community Technical College. Thanks to all you guys for helping us bring this to the people on BSN. So as I said earlier, 13-1 Breathitt, top of the fourth. Mr. Tipton's up. He grounded out to short his first at bat. Yep, I was going to say, did he call that a strike?
Thought he said strike. But
thought he did too, but they didn't
put a ball on the board.
Interesting. He didn't give the big Leslie Nielsen, hey, but that's a strike because he swung. How can I know I've seen that one? So 2-1 to Tipton. Tipton's a cleanup batter for Lee County. Ladies and gentlemen, it's not often that you get to be around royalty and things like that and having a suck up play by play man, but we got the boss with us, Brendan. Welcome. Welcome,
thanks,
sir.
Chuck. Well, as I went home to take Carson home and sit down and went to sleep, I'd have been here a little bit early. So got a few pictures down there, but thanks for filling it.
I know.
Thanks for coming in, man. Looking forward to you being the voice of the Breathitt Bobcats baseball this season.
I know how old you are, and I'm not going to tell everybody that I took a nap as well before I came here. So Tipton pulls a walk from Moore, and here comes Jake Jewell, best hitter in Lee County, ready to hit and rips one. Oh, it's up in the air. It's going to drop. Price tried to make a play from second. They're going to throw it because he didn't catch it. It was in short right field, so the second baseman came over, the right fielder came over, first baseman went back, and Tipton had to wait on it since it was a pop fly, and it got between all of them, and he almost threw him out at second. So, good.
What a great to be here for the first game this year. I tell you, we've not the Bobcats played already double-digit games, first game we've been able to do. So, look forward to bringing you several more here before we get to the 55th District Tournament. Of course, baseball tournament, a season just flies by on us.
And, it does. You get the end of school, you get everything going on, graduations, and before you know it, school's out and baseball's over.
Back here tomorrow night, the Estill County Engineers will come calling. Should be a good one here on BSN. So, folks, tune in. Join us. First time Matthew and I have been here, so we're getting camera positions staked out for you. Try to bring you the best action.
Looks like he's showing bunts. Jake Mays faking everybody out. Everybody moving around for Breathitt, covering the bases. Coaches are coaching. Here goes Mays again. He's not hiding. Oh, and he pulls back. Almost fakes.
Throw to third is wide.
Way into left field. That's twice he's done that. But here comes the throw to home. And that's not going to be good enough. Tipton scores on the throw into left field.
Yep, good game here from a young guy experience for Breathitt County. These guys out there in varsity action start getting some action for the future.
There's a lot of youth on the field on both teams.
Yeah, future, lots of young kids here in the Breathitt system. Tell you, but impressed with Tatum Moore there on the mound. Got good arm action for a young man, good velocity.
He's ahead of Mays, 1-2. No outs. Runner at third. That's Jewell. And there's a strike. And that'll send him back to dugout. Strike three.
Apologize, folks. We got here. We usually take this front screen out here to be able to broadcast here right behind the plate, but it looks like the staff here at Breathitt's bolted that back in on it. So we'll see what hell we can get us a better view.
Matt and I talked about that. We'll work on that.
Yeah. First pitch from
Xavier Martin. He struck out the first time. Another eighth grader, Brendan. That's another young man getting some action.
To say, Coach Combs got this field in great shape here.
That's awesome.
Of course, looking ahead this year, region going to be down at Powell County. Great facility down there at the park.
Who would you? I think they're 14-4 or something like that.
That's some good kids, man. So I'll tell you what,
the definite contender for the regional.
Yeah, Coach Spencer's title. Got a couple of kids down there already signed to play with Georgetown, I believe, maybe Del Rosario, and the other young man, Austin. God, better not say names. I'm not looking at a roster right now, but no, we played against them in travel ball for a while, and they've got some really good talent down there. So I look forward to seeing them here soon.
So. Ball got away from catcher, and Jewell glided in for another run. So that makes it 13-3.
Of course, Estill coming here tomorrow night. And always a power here in the fourth. Always a good baseball team from Estill County. So it should be a good matchup.
Should be a dandy.
Yeah, Austin Begley is who I was looking for Powell County. Thank you, Matt.
And pitched just inside of Martin, so he's going to get his base at first. So Lee County stirring up the dust here in the top of the fourth. Got a run in, a couple runs in. Man on first, one out. Mr. Cash Harold back up to bat. First time he grounded out to second. Third, sorry.
That one gets through.
Yep. Ball gets by a little. He's going to move, and Martin's going to move to second. Coach Combs is not happy.
Going to make a mound trip.
He's not even going to make the infield. He's just going to have a pitcher-catcher talk here after a couple of wild pitches and passed balls. We just appreciate, again, during this little break, all of our sponsors.
Yeah, well, are we playing that Breathitt Farm Bureau commercial there heavy tonight?
I hear you. I said I don't know those guys, but I know the girls are working that office top-notch.
I can just tell you from the bottom line, we're very thankful for all the folks here that sponsor us on BSN. We try to give you a little break here during baseball season. We bring so much action throughout the year, basketball. Man, very few people around and broadcast as much baseball and softball as we do. Very, very little softball being broadcast throughout the mountains. We do a ton of it between Wolf and Breathitt County, also Wolf and Breathitt baseball. I mean, of course, the games have been so sparse for baseball so far this year, it's been hard to get many on. Lots coming at you here in the next couple of weeks.
You know the old saying, April showers bring May flowers. So hopefully in May we'll have a lot of games.
You know, it's time we take a little break from basketball after that grind of the regional tournaments and then the state tournament for me. Then it's baseball season's half over by the time we get rolling. So, but we get the important part here at the end of the season.
After the talk by Combs, Tatum's back bringing the pitches in. We've got Xavier Martin at second. One out.
No.
Cash Harold up to bat, swinging through it.
I think we got a 55th district matchup here on Friday night, if I'm not mistaken. I know, just to let everyone know, we were talking last night, next Tuesday night, Breathitt and Wolf at Wolf has been moved to May the 1st. We confirmed that. That's Breathitt Academic Boosters here in Breathitt County. We'll be bringing you that one live here on BSN. We always stream the academics along with the sports.
That's what it's all about, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So, Mr. Cole Wilder just broke somebody's heart and we're afraid he got a windshield or a hood. Hopefully it wasn't anybody.
Somebody sure about Farm Bureau.
Well, I'm sure Farm Bureau will hear about that one.
Hope it's big or somebody, right?
Yeah. Wolf County, Lee County, or maybe somebody from Lee County. Robbie McKinney, that might be your problem, not mine.
Yeah,
it's part of the game.
That's why you park out in the front parking lot here at the new Breathitt Elementary School.
What's the – I mean, and they're still kind of – well, there's another one, guys. We'll look out.
No, not over at Sebastian out here at Breathitt. I park on the other side of the school.
Cole's wielding his vengeance against the cars parked close to the baseball field tonight. So Cole Wilder playing left field, made some good plays tonight. Out and left to save a few runs.
Okay, we're going to have a pickoff here. More picks off. Steps back, and Miles is going to run it down.
Not many people going to outrun Miles Holland.
Going to be out number three.
So Martin gets out, and we're going to go to the break.
Head to the bottom of the fourth.
Here we go. So we're going to move into the bottom of the fourth. Breathitt County ahead, 13-3. This is Bluegrass Sports Nation.
Since 1962, Citizens Bank and Trust of Jackson has been proud to serve the community. They care about the people of Breathitt County and are the only locally owned bank in the community. With two branches in Jackson and one in Beattyville, they're never too far away when you need them. And with the latest innovations in banking, keeping track of your finances has never been easier. Helping to grow Breathitt County as leaders for over 60 years. That's Citizens Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
During a loss, we realize that your loved one is your most valuable possession. At Breathitt Funeral Home, we consider it an honor to serve your family. We've recently made some big changes, but not only to the building. We have lowered our prices to what we believe are the lowest in Breathitt County. We offer payment plans for prearranged funerals, and we will honor prearrangements from any other funeral home. Breathitt Funeral Home, premium service at an affordable price. When only the best will do.
Come see us at Jackson Medical Clinic Family Healthcare in Jackson for all your medical needs. Now also offering behavioral healthcare services. The clinic is open 7 days a week and will have new extended hours of operation beginning on January 1st, 2024. Hours of operation will be from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. Monday through Thursday, and 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Saturday and Sunday. With a hometown atmosphere, come let our family take care of yours.
All right, we're back quickly here in the bottom of the fourth. Breathitt, they're ready moving this one on. We're trying to get a few sponsors in. Jaden Hudson steps up for Breathitt, or is it? Yeah, Jaden Hudson.
We're going to get Chuck some score sheets here for the next game.
Yeah, I had one last time and wanted to print one off when I printed the lineups off, and that nap that I was talking about was calling my name, and I didn't print it off. But we'll be ready. We're learning. I've got something different every time. I got a pencil this week. Got to try to do this with a pen.
We'll get you set up for bar night.
Jaden pops one foul. It's going to get out of the play there for Mr. Peters at third. Well, he runs back. Shout out there to Jackson Medical Clinic for sponsoring us here at BSN and Breathitt Funeral Home, Mr. Jeff Hamilton, one of the finer fellows in town.
Yeah, you got to get that in. No matter if there are no three-pointers in the baseball or softball action, you got to get a Breathitt Funeral Home three-pointer in. That's become a trademark across the mountains of BSN.
I'll have to come up with something. There's Hudson rips one down to first, and Jewel bobbles a little bit, recovers, and gets him out.
I guess we could talk to Jeff about bunts. There's a Breathitt Funeral Home bunt.
There we go. We'll come up with something. I will try. Hudson, there he is. Here's Adam Spencer up. Adam's seen some running duties tonight. Now he's getting his payback to get a little at bat. Adam's an eighth grader. Right over his head. No. Got some unruly fans over here upset about calls, balls, and strikes.
Spencer.
Adam reaches out and knocks one into center.
That's a gapper.
Yep. Got well,
he's center fielder done a good job cutting that one off. Bare handed out there.
Good play. Can't really see who that is. I think that might be Mays. So Adam Spencer on first with a good base hit. And here comes his brother Wyatt. Following up, Wyatt's a freshman. Let's see if they can quick throw over to first. Oh. Ball gets away from Harold. He recovers. Spencer staying at first.
Chuck's cracking me up.
I know.
He's right between windows. He's dodging around. If I could, I would have put a camera on this, Matthew. I mean, this is the most activity I've seen out of a broadcaster.
Hey, listen, do it with all you got or don't do it at all. There's a pop fly to Jewel, and he's trying to reach it, but it got down on him. And Adam was halfway between first and second, so he moved on to second.
Took the gymnastics here.
Tough play by Jewel.
Number 32, Mr. Tatum Moore.
Pitcher Tatum Moore coming up.
The second number 32.
There's a couple 32s out there. Tatum, that's the middle school. If you couldn't tell, Tatum's a big part of that middle school team. It's a middle school jersey. Like you said, great time for some experience for these kids. One out. Adam Spencer on second. Wyatt Spencer on first. And Tatum pops one up into right. He's down. Going to the line, and it gets down. How did you see that? Are you watching on the camera?
Yeah, I could just tell.
So he got down in front of the right fielder, and they're loaded up for – my score sheet is just completely worthless right now because they put so many different people in there.
Don't forget, sir, I played this game on the three.
Jacoby Lynch. Mr. Jacoby is going to step up.
Interested to see Jacoby. He's had a couple of really big summers here the last couple of summers. A really good-looking kid. You know, lots of good genes there with J.K. and the little family. And interested to see him swing the bat here.
Absolutely. Fought an elbow injury during the winter, and looks like he's recovered from that. Always known to have a big arm. see how he does with his bat with the bases loaded. And he's trying to frame that, but he did not get the call, so 1-1. Top of the fourth, or the bottom of the fourth, folks, one out. Breathitt up 13-3. Lee County fought back a little bit. There's a look like a little bit high. Tipton kind of cracks me up framing that. He's like, are you going to call this or not? Come on. 2-1. Inside. But, oh,
strike.
He moved like it was inside, and we all said inside, and the umpire said, nope. Inside corner. 2-2. So Harold delivers a little bit high, so he runs it full. Full count. One out. Brendan, what do you do? You send anybody here? What are we going to do? We're just going to play it safe.
I just want out. In this type of situation, you give a chance to swing the bat. And he does, fouls it back. Just a learning experience here for these young guys. So put them in some situations, make them learn situational baseball.
You can practice all you want, but until you get into a game and get the pressure of a game and situations and the different places you can be, pitch low, there's a walk, and that's going to walk one in. Adam Spencer crosses the plate, makes it 14-3. But until you're put in those situations in a real game,
number 15, Mr. Caleb Bailey.
Like I said, it wouldn't surprise me to see these two teams battling out regional championships down the road with their youth they've got out on this field right now. So Bailey comes up for his second at bat. And Bailey's a freshman. His dad's an assistant principal at SES. Fourteen to three. You got 14, don't you, Matt?
Yeah.
Wrong side, dude. So strike to Bailey. Sun goes down. Shadows are stretching across the field here at Breathitt High. You should say Breathitt High Field. This really isn't Breathitt High. If you've ever been here, the baseball field's in between the elementary school and the middle school, or the upper elementary school, the former middle school, right on the lake. Bailey reaches out and fouls one back.
On the lakeside, we've got a come up with something. We've got, I've been thinking about that. We were doing it last night a little bit. We got the riverbank. We got the woods that we play in. We need a name for these fields over here.
It's true.
May have to have a little contest on that, Chuck.
Bailey's pops one to the kit. Oh, Angel reaches back just out of his reach. Throws the second, trying to get.
And everybody's safe.
Jacoby at second, but everybody's safe. And Bailey gets an RBI and moves them all around.
Of course,
15-3.
Of course, mercy rule here is 15 after 3 or 4, so a couple more. Bobcats could end this one here in this bat, at bat.
Here's some kid, I don't know. Last time,
looking specimen.
We gave him he's a good looking like his dad.
Cheer up. Just cheer crap now.
Chase Hobbs, I am a middle of the road broadcaster right now. Watching my kid smack one to third. Oh, and fielder's choice is going to go to third. He better hustle. So he does get an RBI out of that.
Drives in another one.
Hits it right and littles in no man's land and gets out at third for two outs.
That'll bring up Miles Holland. Miles popped up to the shorts. Well, second baseman last time. Back.
Seen this kid play a few times too.
You get out a lot, Chuck.
What's that?
Said you get out a lot.
I know. Miles and my son and Aiden Combs, a few of these other kids traveled when they were younger.
When they throw to first, that's not going to be in time. That's going to score a run.
And here comes
Bailey will come on.
Bailey to come in. Yeah, Harold, there's a shot back to Harold real fast, came off of his body, and wanted to throw the third, hesitated a little bit, and the guy was already there, and then he threw the first, threw it over the head of Jewel a little bit. He knocked it down, but enough to score another run, so it's 17-3 Breathitt. So the winning runs at second. Jake Fugit's up to bat, seventh grader. Coach Osborne's going to come out and talk it over with the group and reaching for the right-hander.
So we have a pitching change.
We're going to change pitchers, looks like. So, Matt, if you want to take just a second and give people a break from me, then we'll do that. We'll be right back in just a second with a new pitcher. This is Bluegrass Sports Nation.
Mm-hmm. What keeps you going? Your love for the game? Your teammates? A victory? At ARH Orthopedics, our goal is to keep you pain-free so your body can keep going. There's no time for discomfort in your joints or ligaments caused by an injury. ARH Orthopedic providers specialize in treatment plans, from non-surgical and surgical options, so your care is entirely centered around you. Visit arh.org/ortho to find an orthopedic provider near you. ARH, more for Appalachia.
Wolf County is widely known as a rock climbing and hiking destination, but is now quickly becoming known for its great restaurants and entertainment venues. Venues like Skybridge Station, where you can see live music on the weekends or go to Tuesday Night Trivia, Kell's Patriot Pizza, Spanks Franks, Dixie Freeze, The Finca, 145 Steakout, which has live music most weekends, The Brick, Red Point Barbecue, and Bites and Bargains. Wolf County is naturally gorgeous, and Wolf County Tourism invites you to stop in and try one of these great restaurants on your next visit.
Appalachian Wireless is all in on tech madness right now. Select devices get up to $500 off on the Appalachian Advantage Unlimited or nationwide mix and match plans with renewed or new lines. Plus, use a trade-in for additional savings of up to $250 for a possible savings of up to $750. See AppalachianWireless.com for complete terms and conditions. It's tech madness with up to $750 off because we are you. We are Appalachian Wireless.
Oh, I knew Brendan knows this.
Oh, yeah. Didn't beat the live wire, baby.
Early Motley Crue. That's what I just don't care. I said, this is early stuff.
Yeah, that's good stuff. Back when they were on the strip at the Whiskey Go-Go.
All right, guys, we're back. We had a pitching change. Mr. Xavier Martin coming in, the lefty. Finished it up here for Lee County. Trying to get out of the inning. Two outs. Runners at first and second. We got Price on second. And hauling on first, and Jake Fugit up to bat.
Speaking of the crew, that was the only thing I missed when I went to the Super Bowl in L.A. We went ahead down to the Whiskey a Go-Go, but figured that we may end up in a body bag if we went down there, so we didn't go.
And I can't really tell what you can hear on the radio, but or on YouTube, Facebook, wherever you're listening, but. Shout out to Kara Cox for some great music in between innings and during changes. She's playing some good 80s.
Gonna be thrown away.
Wild throw. They were trying to get Price out of second, so he's gonna move on to third, and he better hustle.
He's down again.
Head down. Oh, his mom's gonna
Mama
be
Ray
about
is gonna
that.
Be doing some laundry tonight because JT is all over the field out there tonight.
Somebody get the fire extinguisher and put those shoes out. Timing him with the sand dial. So he moves into third. Holland follows up to second. We lost Brendan somewhere. Jake Fugit ready to.
That struck me as funny, Chuck.
Oh, Lord. Price boys are not known for their fleet of feet. We may be fine-looking men, but we're not fast on the base paths.
I can tell you the Miller boys are the same, son.
Yeah.
You ain't got nothing on us, brother.
That's right. So here's Martin. Martin brings
good
in
pitch. That's a pitch. Nice breaking ball for Martin there.
I thought it broke, but I couldn't see it looking between the posts. So he's 2-2, even here with two outs in the bottom of the fourth. Breathitt's trying to get another run across the plate. There's a wild pitch. And
here comes Thomas. JT to end it, and JT. He does.
And maybe see if they call it. Yep, they do.
That'll be enough.
The folks that got away from the catcher but tipped him, but that'll make the ball game.
Yeah. Well, Chuck, thanks for doing it. You know, always. In fact, we asked Chuck and Seth to start doing these Breathitt games because we do so much now. We need that. And they're good guys, good at good announcers. We'll learn how to do these games. And we'll.
This is my second time, so we're learning. Hopefully, we'll get better every time. So
tomorrow night, we'll not go to a break. We'll just close her out here and say, everybody, come back tomorrow night for Estill and Breathitt. Should be a really good one. So we'll jump up here and we'll bring that one to you. Maybe get a few pictures. I got a few pictures tonight. Might get them up tonight. Got to get ready to try some cases tomorrow. So, Chuck, I got to be at work.
All right.
We'll see you tomorrow night here, folks. I'm Bluegrass Sports Nation. Thanks for joining us.
Good evening.